obviously wish we were preparing for game two in OKC instead of here today, but you know, we've talked about our goal. Step one, get into the playoffs, which we did last year. But step two, stay there and advance. And obviously, we're disappointed that this year we didn't continue that goal. So while the year didn't end as we hoped, I do think a lot of bright spots. De'Aaron and Domas' career years in a lot of ways. De'Aaron with leading the league in steals. I believe he had his most points per game. And Domas, obviously, with his double-doubles, triple-doubles throughout the year. Keegan strides on both ends in year two. Keon, when we had some injuries down the stretch, really showing up big for us. And so a lot to build on. I think looking forward, we're excited. I'm excited. Disappointed we didn't make the playoffs, but we do get a lottery pick in addition to, I think, a good base of assets and flexibility to go and improve this team and get back to the playoffs where we want to be. So happy to take questions.
Money, when Mike got the job, he talked about the importance of building a culture. And from your perspective, how do you think that you guys as a group have done in cultivating that? And just what's your evaluation on the time that he's had in this role?
Yeah, I think the biggest thing is what we've seen, especially the last couple of years, guys wanting to be here in Sacramento, wanting to be a part of what we're doing here, guys coming here wanting to stay, guys from elsewhere wanting to come and join. And, you know, Coach Brown, his staff, our players all deserve a ton of credit for that. And obviously, you know, winning helps. Well, I think you guys got to talk to Malik yesterday, and you know he had some great comments. I think the fans, the love they have for him, that's reciprocated. We love Malik. He's obviously been a huge part of what we've done the last couple years. You know, sadly missed him at some key points down the stretch. We could have used Malik, but and not just what he does on the floor, but off the floor, his attitude and mentality and obviously his swag and everything that Malik brings. So, you know, obviously we'll have those conversations when the time comes, but what he's done for us has been a huge part of our resurgence the last 2 years.
Monty, do you kind of have a feeling of how that might play out already? Like, do you have like a confidence to you in knowing that what you guys can do?
Yeah, I think for us, you know, I won't get into any of those specifics, but you know, credit to Malik. He gets to make a free agent decision. It's, you know, I think we'll put our best foot forward. We you know, he loves it here. We love him. And so hopefully we'll be able to do that when the time comes.
And just following up on that, like, you know, having you, every time you're here in this city, you've been in this position, everyone says how important the offseason is. It seems like it's always important, right? Do you feel like any heightened sense of urgency this year based on, you know, even though it's only a two-game in the wins-loss column, I mean, it's still rather, you know, similar to what you guys have experienced. Do you feel like there's any heightened sense of urgency based on previous seasons now that you have so much of a sample size to you guys?
I think I would say we always feel urgency, especially, you know, with in this league, you know, windows don't last forever. But certainly another year, you know, I think we've seen a lot of what we can build on, a lot of success. We know a lot of the guys and what they can do for us, you know, whether it's play-in, playoffs, big games. So, and I think at the same time, we're well positioned to take advantage of that and figure out ways that we can improve the team. We'll have to look, obviously, internally, like we always do, and then externally through draft, free agency, trade. I think in all three of those, we have abilities to improve the team as well.
Monty, though you obviously just alluded to how this season kind of the end result was kind of disappointing for you guys in the short term, When you look at this team from a long-term perspective, how do you kind of view this season from that point of view? Just with the context knowing that you, from a long-term, again, from a long-term point of view, you want to eventually be contending for championships.
I think if you look at this from a two-year horizon, you know, I'm proud of what this team accomplished. So, 94 wins over 2 years. I think us and Denver, the only two teams in the West that won 46 both of the last 2 years. We broke the playoff drought. A lot to be positive on. At the same time, those expectations got raised last year. We knew they were coming for us, and that's a great thing. I mean, it's a great thing for our organization. I'm not as eloquent as Coach Brown, but I think he said pressure is a privilege, right? And that's fantastic. I love that 46 wins and beating Golden State in the play-in is not good enough anymore, and that's true.
Monty, over here. Number 13th overall pick officially. Do you guys have a plan for that position right now in terms of, is that something where you might trade it? Do you anticipate picking someone there? And if so, where do you think that pick could go to?
Yeah, I think credit to our scouting group. They've already been on all this throughout the years. They always are. So, myself, Wes, our executive group, we're starting to dive in a little more. I think we're excited about, where that pick is. I try not to get into all the how good is this draft stuff because I think we're not very good at always predicting those. But even then, I think once you get past the top five or so of a draft, these things are, usually even out year to year. So, we're excited so far about what we'll see at 13. At the same time, could it be used in trade to improve the team? Of course. So, we'll have to look at all those things, weigh those options. I do think one of the silver linings here is, a lottery pick that we can use in one way or another to improve the team.
Hey, Monty. Mike was asked about his contract situation. There's been some reporting on that. Is that just what's your assessment of the job, that he's done here thus far? And what would your recommendation be to ownership at this stage?
Yeah, I think, as I talked about, you look at a two-year horizon here, which is when Coach Brown and his staff came in, and a lot of positives. We're certainly disappointed this year. Mike and I will sit down and try to figure out how we get back to where we want to get to. We'll have all those conversations here starting soon.
Monty, the West this year is pretty extreme in terms of just the amount of talent overall. There's not necessarily a roadmap to look to if teams are going to stay that good or if some are going to drop off a little bit. You can't really predict that. I'm just curious, when you look at the Western Conference, the competitiveness of the Western Conference, how much pressure do you feel to make moves immediately to try and compete with that right away versus staying put, staying patient, and believing in the growth, kind of similar to like a Denver Nuggets of a few years ago?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I've been in the West now, I think, 18 seasons, and it feels like it's almost always like this. So, I think last year, for really, a cornucopia of reasons, we were able to get to the 3 seed. Win 48, we were rather healthy. That middle part of the West was more centered around 44 to 46. And we were able to come out on top, some career years from guys. And this year, we saw the depth of that 46 was, I think, would have been the 4 seed last year. And this year we had two teams facing off in the 9-10 game with 46 wins. So, but that's what the West is, and that's what we're competing against. And I think you got 10 teams that were really darn good this year. And then you got, five teams that have a lot of promise coming for us. So it's not something where you can, in the West, where you can bide your time and just wait it out forever. Those five teams down there are coming sooner or later as well. So I think for us, it's balancing those two things. We do have a rather young group, but we're not so young that our horizon is 5-6 years in the future. Like, we're ready to win now. We've clearly done that at some level the last 2 years, and you know, we got two guys who were all-stars, all-NBA guys last year. I would argue had even better years this year. And we had a lot of positives around them. But those guys are right smack in their prime. And so, you know, we're built to win now, and we're going to figure out ways to improve the team internally or externally, however we can.
What's up, Monty? Just two quick ones. On the Malik front, you do have a cap on obviously what you guys can spend on him. Does that make your side of the negotiations simple, or is it about fit and role and all that? Like, you know, how do you kind of view that?
Yeah, I won't get into like the obviously the cap and numbers part of it. I think the great thing, I think number one thing you want is that you want that player to be here, and Malik wants to be here. Number two is, we want him, and we love Malik, and we know he fits, right? He fits what we're doing. I don't know if the sixth man's been finalized yet. He should win sixth man of the year pretty clearly. I don't know. You guys all get to vote for that, so you guys can tell me. But what he does for us, you know, obviously on the court, fantastic. But really, I think the off-court stuff is what makes him even more special for this group. And, you know, so I think for Malik, you know, credit to him, he gets to make a decision, and, you know, we'll hope it's here.
I believe that award is announced tonight, by the way. But on the first round pick front, how do you view the balance? You sound excited to get the pick, but also obviously then it now sends that one to Atlanta next year, top 12 protected. How do you view kind of the balance there and the step-in rule and just kind of the impact of that?
Yeah, I think there's been some, you know, some reporting out there about, you know, what it does to our pick packages and things. But, you know, we have a lottery pick. We only owe one pick in the future. And so we'll have plenty of pick power, I think, to go and do whatever we want. And, again, there's two ways to do those. You pick them. And I think, you know, credit to, you know, Phil Jabbour and our staff. We've done, I think, pretty well in the draft certain years. And you can trade those. And we've done that as well. The Kevin Huerter trade in particular. So, you know, I think we'll have opportunity there. And, you know, look, at any time you get to pick inside the top 15, you got a chance to get a pretty darn good player. And so it's, you know, certainly I wish that pick was going to Atlanta when I was trying to figure out how to stop the Thunder right now. But, you know, we'll use it to our advantage.
Monty, few seasons back, I think after the second COVID year, you came out, you expressed a little disappointment about the defense. But it seemed like, you know, compared to last year, the offense was incredible. But the defense this season has really improved. And Mike and his coaching staff have been working really hard, you know, to shore up that area. Just want to get your thoughts on, you know, how the defense is progressing, and if you see anything else that, you know, can improve it as well.
Yeah, I think it was obviously good to see the improvement there. I think we got right around average this year, which is, you know, certainly a huge jump from where we were when I started. And, you know, I think for us, whatever we can do that translates to wins, and, you know, like we talked about, 46 wins is generally a pretty good year. It's not good enough in the West, and it may not be good enough going forward. So whether that's further improvement from our defense, getting our offense back to where it was, you know, I think we lost about a point and a half off our net rating, and we dropped two wins. So we got to figure out how to not just get those back, but then more. But that's one step in the right direction, and we're going to continue to have to figure out ways to tick those numbers upwards.
Monty, you guys had a pretty healthy sample size with this group, and as you approach the offseason, what are maybe some priorities for you in terms of the roster, like what specific needs that you think to get to the point where you can get back and exceed the win total of a couple of years ago?
I think certainly we have to figure out internally. You know, we blew some leads, lost some games that, you know, we wish we could have won. You know, try to shore those up. I know Mike touched on that. Continued internal development. I'll point to, you know, Keegan's defense this year from start to finish was a huge jump for a second-year player. Keon Ellis, I think, is a great success story for our, you know, from identifying him as an undrafted player Great development and success in the G League last year, and then biding his time and stepping in when injuries hit. We just need more and more of those internal success stories, and then we'll look externally. Like I said, we have the 13th pick in the draft and probably 45 in the second. I think we have a lot of flexibility with our tools. You know, you can trade into the MLE and BAE now, the biannual. So that's another thing you can do. And then, we'll have to look at, potential trade opportunities to build there. But I think, we're excited about how we're positioned going forward. Obviously disappointed with where it ended, but I think we'll be able to get to where we need to. And, our group's already boots on the ground working hard.
Monty, I guess to piggyback off of that last question, Mike Brown has said several times that it's not that hard to go from bad to good, but it's hard to go from good to great. Obviously, with the historic season that you guys had last year and with the raised level of expectation going into this year, in your eyes, why do you feel it is so difficult to get to being great? And what do you think, in your, through your perspective, you've been in the league a long time, what do you think the Kings have to do in order to achieve greatness?
Well, I don't know if Mike said not that hard. It's hard to win in this league. It's hard to get to the playoffs in this league. But then it's a little bit of math question. There's 8 first round spots in the West, and then there's 4 second round and 2 conference finals, and everybody's going for that. And I think especially it's great for the league, the play-in and all those different things, the in-season tournament. Teams are trying to win. A lot of teams in the league up and down, if you count them, that's the large majority of the league is trying to win. So, it just means that, there's fewer spots. It's going to be harder. At the same time, last year, maybe we snuck up on people a bit. This year, we certainly didn't. You win 48, you're the 3 seed. You take the defending champs to game 7, people are going to be ready for you. We're just going to have to continue to fight there. And then, lastly, the West is what it is. There's the year in, year out, there's going to be great teams there. So we're going to have to put our best foot forward. We're going to have to get better to crack into, our goal, get into the top 6 first and foremost. So we lock that in and then, pursue top 4 to get home court. And then, our hope is that we're at some point hosting second round and conference finals here. So, but those spots are coveted. Everybody's going for them, and certainly not easy.
Monty, we're talking to De'Aaron a little bit on Monday about the consistency that he's had the last couple of years with your front office and Mike, obviously, because he's been here through a lot of turnover. How do you balance the need in the West specifically to improve the team, but also keeping the consistency of the core intact, not blowing things up and things like that? How do you balance those two things?
Yeah, it's always a balance, and we're always weighing those things. What does this do for us now versus, what will we be able to do in the future? I think there's always going to be movement, shakeup. At the same time, there's also a benefit to guys that have been able to play together that show they fit together. We talked about it. A lot of, I think, the improvement in year 2 defensively is we had a lot of the guys coming back in the same system under Coach Brown and Jordy. Congratulations to Jordy. Brooklyn got a good one. But, I think a lot of those things are benefits as well. And, it's a credit to De'Aaron and Domas and that they lead those guys, that they can go and, put their best foot forward there. So, I think we're always balancing those things. It's not easy. If it was, then, it would just be the answer. But really, that's a lot of that we talk about in those rooms.
Monty, you guys have been really patient as a front office and as a team in general in terms of making moves. You brought back those core guys from last year. Do you anticipate keeping that core together? I know when I say core, I mean more than just Domas, De'Aaron, and Keegan. I'm talking Kevin, HB, Davion, or is that – or is it that the untouchables just De'Aaron, Keegan, and Domas right now?
I would point to, I think for our group, we've shown, when the time comes that and the opportunities there, we'll be aggressive. We've done it. We're certainly, it's not something where, we said, we had success. Let's just roll it out. We're not sitting on our hands. We're out there looking at all the opportunities. Obviously, in the last couple go rounds, we've generally not made a bigger move. But you know, we've been in some conversations. We always will. We have to find out what's out there, and we got another opportunity. You know, this summer we got, like I said, draft pick in the lottery. A lot of flexibility. I think, look, we have a lot of players that have contributed to winning. And, you know, I think the league sees that. You know, Brooklyn just wanted to come in and, you know, take our number one assistant because of what Mike and the players have done here. So, you know, we got to always evaluate those things. And, you know, it's, you know, for us, I think it's putting ourselves in a position that we can take advantage of those opportunities when they come. And I think we're in position to do that this summer.
Monty, building off a lot of what you just said there, most of us, especially me, ignorant to the conversations that were happening during the trade deadline, for example, but you see the jump and how different the Dallas Mavericks looked after the trade deadline and other teams, not just in the West, but around the league did. Is there any regret or remorse to staying put or not making any moves on the deadline, considering how the season ended, or are you able to kind of separate yourself from what other teams do and just focus on you?
Yeah, we focus on ourselves, and you know, I think one benefit we'll have on those teams going forward is probably more flexibility, more draft assets, and how can we put those best to use? You know, at the same time last year, we were able to, you know, stay healthy post deadline and make a run, and you know, who knows if Kevin Bilic, you know, are able to Trey as well, you know, was down for a while. You know, if those guys stay healthy, maybe we get another couple wins and we're in a better position. But yeah, no, look, every move won't always work out. I love the process that our group goes through. And I think, you know, it was funny. I was talking to my 5-year-old, he's playing baseball and he got upset when he got out. I said, you know what the best baseball players, you know, they only make it 3 out of 10 times. And right. All of these things, all these, batting averages, all these decisions, we're not going to bat 1,000, but you know, we want to just put ourselves in the best spot that we can make the next move that we need to do, the right move, and all those types of things. So, yeah, no regret. Excited for where we are going forward, because I think we'll have a lot of opportunity.